The chief of the Philippine Armed Forces denying reports its Navy vessel was driven away by the Chinese Coast Guard around Scarborough Shoal. See, the Chinese Coast Guard claimed it took necessary measures to drive away a Filipino ship along the disputed waters. But General Romeo Bronner Jr. dismissed that, saying it is nothing but a mere propaganda.
It's not true. There is no truth. If ever kung may parko tayo doon, hindi tayo palalayasin. We will not, hindi tayo papayag na exclusive economic zone.
A maritime law expert echoing that statement while also expressing concern China could just be baiting Philippine ships to respond to constant harassment.
They're probably creating stories for their domestic audience, number one, or to justify some other action that they will take. Government must not allow itself to be provoked into making the first move, into giving China any excuse for an overwhelming and disproportionate response. The government should also continue to stand its ground based on international law and insist on China's compliance with the law and the peaceful modes of dispute settlement.
As promised, a Philippine House committee scraps the confidential funds of five government agencies, including those led by the President and Vice President. A total of 1.23 billion pesos were stripped from the Departments of Agriculture, ICT, and Foreign Affairs, as well as the OVP and Education Department. Agencies in charge of protecting the West Philippine Sea will instead receive the funds.
We believe that the House of Representatives is on the right side of history. We are responding to the call of the times, and the volatile situation in the West Philippine Sea calls for the immediate and decisive action to protect our national sovereignty.
Meanwhile, the House also dismissed allegations the chamber has 1.6 billion pesos in secret funds. It also clarifies some agencies, like the Justice Department and the President's Office, will still receive confidential funds next year. The Philippine Senate, for its part, also vows to scrutinize proposed confidential funds of civilian agencies. Senate Minority Leader Coco Pimentel believes the office of the president must also be stripped of secret funds. President Marcos's office was spared by the Congress, as it still retains over 4 billion pesos in confidential and intelligence funds next year. Senate Majority Leader Joel Villanueva, meanwhile, assures the public they will scrutinize the budget to ensure it will be polished before passing. For Senator Sonny Angara, only agencies with defined fund spending will be considered for next year's confidential funds allocation.
I think that's the rule of budgeting. You show that you use the funds properly, nagastos mo sa tamang panahon, sa tamang paraan, at saka sa tamang mga layunin, at dun mo makikita, dun yung pamantayan ng Kongreso sa pag-alat ng mga budget. We discuss it usually in caucus and then we reach a consensus para sa floor medyo smooth sailing na yung decision. Nagkaisa na kumbaga dun sa napag-usapang decision.
The country's transportation chief names attorney Mercy Lanes as the officer in charge of the Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board. This comes a day after the regulator's chairperson, Teofilo Guadiz III, was suspended amid corruption allegations. A transport group, meanwhile, believes the change in leadership does little to address corruption at the agency.
Napakalaki po nito. Imposible naman po kay Chairman Guadiz lamang po lahat ito. Kami maghahantay po kami hanggang maitama po itong allegasyon ng korupsyon na ito.
Manibela, meanwhile, says it will push through with its planned transport strike starting October 16th despite the suspension of Guadiz. And let's get an update on the weather now from Pag-asa forecaster Benison Estereja. Good morning.
Good morning, Ms. Kat, and to all our viewers. As of 3 in the morning, the low-pressure area inside the Philippine area of responsibility was estimated at 750 kilometers east of Giwan, Eastern Samar. This low-pressure area has a slim chance of becoming a tropical cyclone in the next 24 hours. However, it will bring cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms over many parts of the country, including Metro Manila, Mimaropa, Calabarzon, Bicol Region, Visayas, and Mindanao. So there may be possible flash floods or landslides in those areas due to moderate to at times heavy rains. Over the rest of Luzon for today, expect some partly cloudy to cloudy skies with some isolated rain showers or thunderstorms. Range of temperature for Metro Manila is from 25 to 31 degrees Celsius. Another tropical cyclone has been spotted outside PAR as of 3 in the morning. Typhoon with international name Bolaven, located 2,310 kilometers east of southeastern Luzon and will not enter the Philippine area of responsibility. And that's the latest from Pagasa Weather Forecasting Center. This is Benison Estareja reporting.
Thank you for joining us this morning. And for that update, Pagasa forecaster Benison Estareja. Let's find out what stories our North America Bureau is pursuing right now from our correspondent, Henny Espinosa.
Hey guys, here are news-making headlines for Filipinos in North America. We begin with home surveillance video released by the police showing why they arrested a Filipina for allegedly trying to poison her Air Force husband. It was this home surveillance video, date-stamped July 18, showing Melody Feliciano Johnson pouring liquid into a small bottle from what appears to be a bleach container, then going to the kitchen and pouring the contents into a coffee maker, that prompted Tucson police to place the Filipina mother under arrest. The 39-year-old has been charged with multiple felonies, including attempted first-degree murder, for allegedly trying to poison her Air Force worker husband, Robbie Johnson.
Okay, about 50 minutes ago, while I was at work, I noticed her come over to the coffee maker and she did something. So I've got my tester. I'm going to add the water to see if there's chlorine and pH is off.
ABS-CBN News obtained from Tucson Police multiple videos that show Melody pouring liquid into a coffee maker and Robbie testing the water several times in July.
Like I do every day, I clean this thing out after I test it. This back is very slippery right now from after I rinsed. It smells like bleach.
Melody remains at the Pima County Jail in Arizona on a $250,000 bond. Prosecutors asked for a high bond because Melody is family and a recently purchased home in the Philippines. Melody's next court hearing is on November 6.
Meanwhile, Vancouver Filipinos are remembering an icon in the community who was known as a champion for immigrant and caregivers' rights.
Professor Aprodicio Lakian may have scaled the heights of academia, but he was never too big to lend a hand to struggling immigrants and care workers. This is how many community leaders in Vancouver remember the professor emeritus at the University of British Columbia. Lakian served as advisor to the Vancouver Committee on Domestic Workers and Caregivers' Rights.
They believed in us, in what are called for landed status. Believe that our work is important to the economy of Canada.
Lakian graduated cum laude in public administration from the University of the Philippines in 1959 and earned his doctorate at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology. He also worked for the United Nations. He and his wife Eleanor co-authored a book called Seeking a Better Life, a study of Filipinos in Canada, that portrays the experiences of Filipinos in Canada from 1957 to 2007.
And finally, in sports, we get to know a Tongan Filipino football player who's making waves in the NCAA.
Young redshirt freshman Noah Fifita. He's going to throw on first down, and Fifita's got a man wide open down the field, and then a missed tackle.
A Filipino Tongan American college quarterback is making waves in the NCAA. Arizona Wildcats quarterback Noah Fifita received Pac-12 Freshman of the Week honors after leading Arizona to a near upset against the number 9 ranked University of Southern California. Fifita, who hails from Huntington Beach, California, threw for 5 touchdowns and over 300 yards against the Trojans. The redshirt freshman has started two games this season and has thrown for over 500 yards and 8 touchdowns in his starts.
And those are the news making headlines today. You can catch more TFC News on the ABS-CBN News website, YouTube channel, and app. I'm Henny Espinosa. Back to you guys at the Rundown.